everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14.0.1 to the public. Now this is available to all iOS 14 supported devices, so if you are able to install iOS 14, have an iPhone 6S for example, all the way to the iPhone 11 Pro Max, you'll be able to install this. Now this came in at 171.2 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro. It was under 200 megabytes on all the devices I installed it on. My iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020, iPhone 7, iPhone XS Max, and any of the others. So it's a pretty small update and it installed fast. Now, if you're on the beta of iOS 14.2, you would need a computer to downgrade to this version. This version is a downgrade from that version. So it will take you a little while to install it that way. You will not be able to do it over the air by removing the beta profile. So just keep that in mind. Now, before we talk about what's new, Apple also released iPadOS 14.0.1, tvOS 14.0.1, watchOS 7.0.1, as well as macOS Catalina 10.15.7, iMovie updates, and Final Cut Pro updates as well. A lot of updates going out today. Now let's take a look at the build number. We'll go to Settings, General, then About, and you can see this build number is 18A393. And so it should offer quite a few fixes. And depending on the device you have, it actually has a modem update. Now my iPhone 11 Pro did not have a modem update, but many people are reporting if you have an 11 Pro Max, there is a modem update. So it just varies from device to device. But if you are having connectivity issues, hopefully that resolves them for you. In fact, 14.0.1 is all about those bug fixes for people that were having issues. So the first one has to do with the default web browser. Now you may be familiar with being able to set your web browser. So if you're using Chrome, for example, go to Chrome, change the default web browser. And if you change it to say Chrome, for example, and then you reboot your device, it would actually go back to Safari. Now, if you reboot, it won't. So they've fixed that with not only browsers, but also email as well. Now they've addressed that issue that a lot of people were complaining about on the iPhone 7. So if you have an iPhone 7 and you saw already that it opened the camera, if you have an iPhone 7, and my battery's low on this device, but if you have an iPhone 7 and you go into the camera, many times this would just be a blank screen and you wouldn't be able to actually see the photo in order to take it and frame the photo properly. So they've actually fixed this on the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus, specifically on those devices. But if you were having it, I would imagine they've fixed it on the others as well. Now they've also fixed an issue that could prevent you from connecting to Wi-Fi networks. I heard from quite a few of you that you were having issues with Wi-Fi, and if you were having issues connecting to specific Wi-Fi networks, well, that should be resolved in this particular update. Now another fix Apple has implemented in iOS 14.0.1 is when you were trying to send mail using specific email providers. Now they don't say who, but maybe you were using Yahoo or Gmail or even Hotmail, maybe the email would not send out. In this case, they've fixed it. Now, I don't know if that's just specific to their own mail app. I would think so, but it could happen with other carriers or other email clients as well going through different carriers. So just keep that in mind. It should be fixed. Now, the final bug fix that they've actually mentioned has to do with widgets. And so they've fixed some widgets, specifically the news widget they call out, saying that these images that weren't showing before will now show. So maybe you're using any of the widgets and the images weren't showing. Hopefully they're showing now. We'll go to news and you'll see now all of the images are showing properly. So just keep in mind that it seems like it's working now. And if it wasn't before and you use news, those should be showing up. Now there's also security updates as well. They have not specified specifically what they are, but they've done some security updates. Whether this is for jailbreaking or anything else, they haven't said, but it looks like they've actually fixed a few different issues with that. And again, they haven't called it out specifically, but it carries across to macOS and iPad and everything else. Now, as far as other issues mentioned, there are no other specific updates to iPad. For example, my 12.9 iPad Pro has the same updates with the news widget and everything else with some of the bug fixes, whether that be with the camera or anything else. It should be working as you would expect. And that means I think most of the widget problems people were having should be resolved at this point. So at this point, it seems like it should be solid. Now, as far as anything else, there are no other particular updates that are mentioned, no new features. I would expect those with iOS 14.1. And honestly, I thought this would be iOS 14.1. So Apple didn't push that out. Instead, they put out 14.0.1 and we're still missing 14.1, but we already have iOS 14.2 betas. So it's kind of getting confusing. Maybe we'll see iOS 14.1 closer to the launch of the iPhone 12, or maybe later on. We really don't know at this point. but it looks like we should have iOS 14.2 beta 2 probably early next week, as they're on a 2-week cycle. I would expect that. Now, many people had great battery life with iOS 14, but many did not. It depends on the device you're using, the applications you're using, but I wanted to show you my battery life currently, and then we'll talk about iOS 14.0.1 battery life in a few days when I do a follow-up. Because it takes a few days to actually use the device, see what it's like, and then you can determine battery life. You really can't run synthetic benchmarks to determine those to give you an accurate battery life over time. So let's go into settings. Under settings, we'll go down to battery. And you'll see battery health is 95%. Now, 95% battery health is pretty good. Apple says 80% after 2 years is normal. And this is pretty good for a phone that's a year old at this point. So if you have 95 or higher, you're doing well, or 90% or higher, you're doing well. But it will degrade over time no matter what you do. The updates don't cause that. They're just simply rechecking the hardware. Now, if we take a look at the last 10 days when I was on iOS 14, I got 6 hours and 41 minutes of screen on time, 7 hours and 1 minute of screen off time. And the screen off time could be music or anything else going on, a workout with your watch or anything like that. And you'll see I used almost 100% of my battery life. So that's not great screen on time. Now, over the past few days with iOS 14.2, still not phenomenal. 3 hours and 34 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 47 minutes of screen off time. So we're at 50% battery. So hopefully over the next few days, the battery life will increase. It will be better and I'll be able to actually have phenomenal battery life. Usually 10 to 12 hours is normal for an 11 Pro Max. So even though there's a lot of things like widgets going on, I'll have a different battery follow-up in a few days or next week at this point with some super accurate information as to what uses your battery. Now, performance on iOS 14.0.1 seems to be pretty solid already. I haven't had any freezing or even hiccups. The frame rate seems really solid, and it doesn't really matter what I'm scrolling through, what app I'm going into. Opening a camera is really fast. Everything seems to be very snappy, and I think you'll be pretty happy with this update. Usually once we get past that initial iOS 14, performance increases, as well as overall bug fixes and stability in general. I would say this is much better than iOS 13.7, at least initially, and even iOS 14 is much better than iOS 13 was at the beginning. So should you update to iOS 14.0.1? Well, I would say at this point, absolutely you should, based off the performance I'm seeing, based off the bug fixes, the security, and of course the additional features with the app library, or if you don't like the app library, removing all the different pages, having a clean home screen, whatever you like, you can fully customize now. So if you're not on iOS 14 yet, don't expect it to degrade anything as far as performance. In fact, I'd say it performs better than iOS 13 on most devices. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. So on my iPhone 11 Pro, you'll see I scored 1,335 for single core, 3,515 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see that it's very similar to what we had before based on the date. So if we take a look at all these different dates here, you can see today versus last year even. Our scores are quite good. In fact, I'm beating what I got on iOS 13. So September 24th, 2020 versus October 15th, 2019, I'm getting much better multi-core scores and about the same single core score. So it really depends on what you're using, but in general, this update should be really solid. Now I did run a Geekbench on this and my iPad Pro, so let me share that with you. And on the iPad Pro, I scored 1,127 for single core, 4,619 for multi-core. And so that should be pretty good. I'm really interested to see how this performs versus that new iPad Air that's coming out in October, along with hopefully new iPhones as well. So be sure to check back for those, as well as a follow-up I plan to have. Usually on Sundays is when I do a follow-up so we can see how good this is as far as performance and stability, bug fixes, and look for a poll on YouTube for that as well. So that's it for iOS 14.0.1. Let me know how it's been for you so far. I know it's only been out a little while, but let me know your experience in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description below. And if I find anything else in this particular update that I didn't mention, I'll be sure to mention that later this week or in the follow-up. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.